Hi, I'm Ed Green, co-founder of Dovetail Genomics and associate professor of biomolecular engineering at UC Santa Cruz. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about my experience with genomics and especially using high throughput sequencing and proximity ligation to make nicely scaffolded genomes from non-model organisms. So my experience in genomics at UC Santa Cruz started with really a project that I wanted to do, a biological question that I wanted to answer. And that was, how does temperature-dependent sex determination work in the American alligator? So American alligators have no sex chromosomes. They have no genetic cue to tell an individual alligator you will develop as a boy or you will develop as a girl. Instead, they sense the environment, and any individual alligator embryo is capable of developing as male or female. This was a great mystery, a cool mystery of biology to me, and we thought, well, we will address this by following gene expression through male alligators and female alligators as they develop. However, because alligator is not a model organism, there's no genome for this, so step one is just to make a genome. So we set about doing that and stumbled onto some technology for scaffolding genomes, which is now the heart and soul of Dovetail Genomics. And we're able to make a fantastically good genome with a large scaffold and allow us to do this RNA-seq work to map the gene expression onto a high-quality genome that we could put together very quickly in a highly contiguous way. This has benefited our research program here, the highly contiguous assembly, because one of the things that wound up being very important in this project was estrogen signaling. We now know that the architecture of estrogen signaling, where the estrogen response elements are, where the CTCF elements are that constrain the estrogen signal, the architecture of this is conserved all the way from mammals to crocodilia. We can find this model of where CTCF binding sites are and estrogen response elements are and where they are relative to genes, oftentimes many tens or even hundreds of kilobases away. We can see this large architecture because the genome is put together in enormous pieces. So the upshot of this is with Dovetail technology, we were able to get a genome assembly from the American alligator very far from a model organism and answer the biological question of relevance to us relatively painlessly.